Hello everyone, today from the Shop Checkers video, and as you have seen, hopefully on the photo before you click this video, I finished socks, and have I knitted all of them? Or whole of them? Let's check them out. Put one on the sock blocker just to let you know and just for you to see how big this thing is. And I love it so much, so cute. Anyway, so how did I knit it? Well, first of all, I went through one of my boxes and I found in the corner that I have a two sock blankets. I think that's how you call them. I have one over here, so check it out. This is what it is. I got it as a gift, actually those two, from Laura. So I'm going to put her YouTube channel down below and I will link it over here. So check it out. She gifted me those a while back and I've never knitted it because it's too pretty. But when I knit for other people, I don't mind to use the good stuff. I have some leftovers, as you can see, and actually what my mom suggested, hi mom, was that I could actually see if the length of the foot will be enough for two socks. Is that? I hope you get what I mean. And as you can see, it matches. So I could do that, and the same way I could insert afterthought heels, but use different yarn for the cuff and have another one. I haven't knitted with this blanket, even though it is a sock blanket. You can actually unravel it and knit something completely different, but the work was put into it. I did not want to waste it. Anyway, but eventually, it happens in your life. There is a person that will fit into those socks. So, first things first. What I did, I put the fabric down and I measured it like this. So it's over 4 inches, not really 4.5, but over 4 inches. And this is 64 stitches. I thought actually it would be 72 stitch, like, you know, circumference, in regards to the stitches in this knitted tube. And when I measured it, this is exactly 4 inches, and this is 64 stitches too. It's slightly different tension. So I presume when you have those fancy, you know, knitting machines, they're just knitting tubes, you can adjust the tension on it somehow. So this sock tube is tighter, and this is more loosey-goosey. But I've knitted already socks for this lovely person. If I have a thumbnail on the screen, I definitely link to the video over here. Kind of cheated a little bit too. So I hold it fingering weight double. I use US size 2, which is 2.75 millimeter needles, and I knitted socks, which, if you're a beginner, go for it. It's way easier and faster to knit. Or if you have some family members or friends whose feet are quite big and you're not such a fast knitter, that's an also option. And the person who received those socks that I showed you loves it and uses it as home socks. So it's so cute, but it's not winter anymore, isn't it? So I thought this will be perfect, even though it is looser gauge. It is fingering weight, only one strand, which should be more breathable, like, you know, and it has some because of that lower tension. As you can see, it's more flexible, but as you can see also too, that you can see through the stitches. You see those stitches are opening up. So that's what we're talking when we're talking about gauge, which you probably would want to know what kind of gauge over here is. And the way to tell you, I'll tell you in 1 inch. Well, we have 7 stitches per 1 inch. When I knit using US size 1, 2.25 millimeters, I get 8 stitches per 1 inch. Normally the gauge is told you in 4 inches, so basically that number of stitches you multiply by 4. So if you have 8, you have 32. If you have 7, you have 28. Yes, my brain had it to work a little bit for that, to be honest. So what about this one? This one is way tighter, and as you see, when I put it flat, it showed me spot on 4 inches. So it should be 8 inches, right? Because if you put it flat, if we have 64 stitches, flat divided by 2, that's 32 stitches per that flat section. So if I take flat section and just deduct 1 inch from it, I should get 8 stitches, right? Yeah, I'm getting 8 stitches. Okay. So if I'm going to knit on this blanket, I'm going to use my one US size I'm going to use knitting needles US size 1, which is 2.25mm needles, because I'm getting that gauge with those knitting needles. But for this one, I wasn't sure. So what I did, because I had to insert after thought heels, and if you've never done that before, check my tutorial. I put it over here and down below. I wasn't sure what kind of needles I should. I knew it's not going to be US size 1 to 2.25mm needles, because no way I'm getting socks like this knitting. So I went with US size 1.5, which is 2.50mm needles. But still, as you can see, if you compare stitches, you may notice that they're gathered, squeezed together a little bit more than these. I don't know, maybe I should have gotten to US size 2, 2.75mm needles. I haven't thought too much about it, but because I got a second hand, oh sugar, I'm going to use them and knit them. I don't have them here with me, so probably I left them down below. Normally what I do, I just have it in my pouch and I put it somewhere that's to show that they are available to be used. So I got circle Addies, those kind of with a golden cable. Circle knitting needles, bought for 9 inches, which is 23 centimeters. I think they're like that, but the main thing that you spot on straight away with them is different lengths of the tips. So one is longer, another one is shorter. I think people were telling me I should be knitting with the longer needle, longer tip, but I actually got used to with a shorter one, so I use the long one just to hold on stitches, and I'm using the small one to maneuver things around, and I find it quite easy. Although because the cord is not so bendy, I kind of feel that I have to squeeze that center all the time, and it's not an issue of the actual material that, you know, you think that it's that you think that I have not that many stitches on that little needle that I have to actually do that. I think the actual cord is too hard for 9 inches, and as you're not aware, maybe I have only two pairs of US size 1 2.25mm needles, and they are Hayahayas, and some people hate the cord because it's very flexible, very bendy, it will do what you want, it doesn't have their own mind into it, although because of that they have a tendency sometimes, if you have a longer cord, to kind of twist, you know. But that's a very simple solution, just put it into the hot water into your cup and then just stretch it, and you know, it's just acrylic cord, so it will work the magic, and that's that. All the cables, most of that could have a coating on them, but inside you have actually a metal wire, I think, if I can say that, and you can notice that with the not Addies, Chagoos, I think that's, yeah, their cord looks like a wire for your bike brakes, something like that. Okay, so I used a long one, actually Chagoos, the red cord that I have. No, so I used over here two sets of needles, like I said, Addies for the cuffs, because I was just knitting it around one way, one rib, finishing with tubular bind off, because I love it and who will stop me. And but for the afterthought heels, I used longer cables, because you do it as in a magic loop, because you're knitting using magic loop. That's its technique, basically. You have a loop over here and loop over there, you know. And I used needles that I received as a gift from a friend. It was an advent calendar, maybe 2 or 3 years ago. And I used those needles only to hold on my stitches for the sleeves for the sweaters. And you may have noticed that. That's kind of my thing, because I don't really want to waste time picking up stitches when you're knitting a sweater. And if it's on the needle, you actually can knit straight away. So don't worry if you're a right-handed knitter. If you're using your left hand and holding a needle over that, doesn't matter what the size of the needle is, but it matters what the right size needle is. So some people, when they're knitting sweaters top down with uncircular needle, knitting needles and the small kind of circumference, and they have not the fixed but interchangeable knitting needles, they sometimes, to knit even faster, change the left needle for a smaller, like maybe half size smaller, and they use the proper needle in the right hand. That way the stitches slides quicker. But you have to be advanced knitter to know how to stop those sliding stitches. And if you're a beginner, people would recommend you probably to use wooden needles, because they have, you know, that surface that will stop, you know, hold on those stitches. You will need to put some effort to move them sometimes. Also depends if you're a tight knitter or loose knitter, the same story. So if you had any issue, yeah, That's that. That's that. And if you're using magic lube, actually, you know, when knitting socks, you could definitely do that if your needles are interchangeable needles, because you can change tips. Do I know? Do I know what kind of yarn I have over here? I don't remember. So maybe Laura will watch this video and let us know down below if she knows, because I don't remember. But the little bits that I have over here, I got from my friend in the Advent. She sent me those little bits from her Advent calendars, and I used them to make them a little bit more fun. You know, so far so good. When someone is sticking out the cuffs, they look quite normal and everything is fine. But once they take the feet out, that will be a blast of the rainbows and colors and everything. So I hope the person will love it. Oh yes, and because the person's feet are 13 inches, the socks over here are 12 inches to give one inch of negative ease. Just saying. I hope you enjoyed this video, the hat video here, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye. Because my camera is blinking, I had to finish fast.